equipment. And this is called a twin tank because it's got two tanks. This is where the air is, of course. And we breathe normal air, it's just compressed, so pushed into the tanks. We're not breathing any other mixed gases. It allows you to breathe normally.
I think the weirdest thing I found was probably something from called the cliff. We were surveying the kind of occupation horizon of the platform. It was being eroded by the tide and the soap. A little trench behind there, an exploratory hole, and this fresh piece of timber came out of there. It's really weirdly shaped, but it looked like it had been attacked by an axe, and it was stratified in the deposit, which is dated to about 8,400 years old. But this piece of wood looked so fresh, with big chunks taken out of it, but I've never seen anything else from Bald the Cliff where you could actually see huge cut marks within a single piece of timber. And then the shape of this thing,
but my master's is a master of science, but definitely social science, I think. So we do use a lot of scientific techniques, especially on Bald the Cliff, where we do like sediment analysis. That's a good way of dating and finding out what like flora and fauna was around at the time.
See the different types. They got lots of flakes and bladelets and little tools. This one here is an interesting one. This looks like the head of an adze that would have come here, that you would sort of half, you would put on a handle, and then you'd use it sort of working wood. Like an axe. And what's important, of course, is the organic material. And just picked up this bit here that had recently coming from a timber. And it's got broken off below, lying on the seabed. And it's a flat piece of timber. Now, I don't know if this one has worked or not. I can't be sure. Can't see any marks without cleaning it up. This piece of timber here, whether it's sort of been worked by humans in the past or whether it's just natural, it's still over 8,000 years old. And you can see how well preserved it is. Just like a piece of wood you could have picked up in the forest a few days ago.
I think it's this. Now this is an Asian elephant tooth. Look at the size of it, and it's really heavy as well. Now you might think, what is an Asian elephant tooth doing on a maritime archaeology discovery bus? Well, It's very similar to the mammoth teeth that we do find on submerged landscapes, so under the water. Well, one of the threats to wooden shipwrecks are small sea creatures called bribble, which are a bit like an underwater woodlice that love to make their homes on these wooden shipwrecks. And unfortunately, as you can see on this one, they like to eat away at it, and they create their homes in there, they eat away the wood, until eventually there wouldn't be very much left of it. So you can see on the screen that they are shells of them here and here, all dotted inside the wood.